It was a rock solid opening when Harry Styles performed his hit Watermelon Sugar. Watermelon Sugar.
That was amazing, man. I mean, I would have worn a shirt for my first Grammys, but, you know, each to his own.
Host Trevor Noah corralled the performers who stuck around to watch each other play. She had two of the biggest hits of the year with WAP and Savage, so it was no surprise Megan Thee Stallion won Best New Artist.
Thank you all so much.
The 26-year-old star also entered the Guinness Book of Records with Beyoncé when Savage won Best Rap Performance, the first time any female artist has won that award. Then more history, as Beyoncé won her 28th Grammy, the most wins ever by a singer.
This is so overwhelming. I've been working my whole life, since 9 years old.
Her own 9-year-old daughter, Blue Ivy, even won one for Best Video for Brown Skin Girl. Australia's Tame Impala and Flume missed out in their categories, while Hillsong was beaten in the Best Christian Music Album by Kanye West, who won his 22nd Grammy, counting the one he threw in the toilet last year. Bruno Mars farewelled one of the artist's 2020 stole, Little Richard. Good girl and there's somebody. While Lionel Richie said goodbye to Kenny Rogers. And Brittany Howard and Coldplay's Chris Martin honoured Jerry and the Pacemakers. Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion didn't disappoint with the first ever live performance of the NSFW hit, WAP. Taylor Swift performed three songs from her hit albums Folklore and Evermore. That's my man, moving my chain. Before becoming only the fourth artist after Frank Sinatra, Paul Simon and Stevie Wonder to win Album of the Year three times.
But mostly we just want to thank the fans.
Hers, I Can't Breathe, which became an anthem for the Black Lives Matter movement, won Song of the Year. And Ringo Starr presented the Record of the Year Grammy to Billie Eilish, who wanted to give it to Megan Thee Stallion.
I was going to write a speech about how you deserve this, but then I was like, there's no way they're going to choose me.
Angela Bishop for 10 News First.